Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from across the world. Our headlines: Turkey passes controversial law to regulate the internet, activists fear censorship. Chilean trade unions prepare for a nationwide protest against President Sebastián Piñera. More slum dwellings demolished without warrant in South Africa's Durban. Colombia's social movements condemn political murders, document more than 1,000 deaths since the peace treaty. On Wednesday, the Turkish parliament passed a controversial amendment to its internet laws, raising concerns of censorship and harassment. The law, supported by the ruling Justice and Development Party of the AKP and its allies, will make it compulsory for social media sites to appoint legal representatives in the country and enforce all court orders. The law will be effective from October 1st. According to the new law, any social media platform based abroad, which has at least a million users, must assign at least one representative in Turkey, preferably a Turkish citizen. The contents of the social media sites, such as Facebook, TikTok and others, can be scrutinized by the courts, and failures to implement their orders would invite hefty penalties. These penalties can range from large fines to advertising bans to bandwidth restrictions. The government, led by Recep Tayyip Erdogan, has argued that it's an attempt to ensure data localization, fight cyber crimes, and ensure that citizens' rights to be forgotten can be maintained. However, privacy and digital rights activists have refuted the government's claims, pointing out that the law makes no such mention of provisions like that. Activists and human rights defenders see it as the beginning of a new era of online censorship. Many have argued that the law violates users' security and anonymity, as well as international protocols and net neutrality, by threatening bandwidth reductions. In our next story, the Chilean Trade Union Confederation, the United Center of Workers, or the CUT, has called for national protests for tomorrow against the right-wing government of President Sebastián Piñera. The CUT called on citizens and workers to hang black flags outside their homes and bang utensils at 9 p.m. for an hour and a half after Piñera's annual public address, the Cuenta Pública. The president announces the government's social and legislative agenda for the year in this national address. The CUT has condemned the government's neoliberal policies and mishandling of the COVID-19 pandemic. They have pointed to the lack of food aid to vulnerable citizens, arguing that it has only further deepened the glaring inequalities in the country. The trade union has demanded progressive taxes to raise resources to combat the pandemic and the crisis that it has entailed as a first step to overcome the country's inequalities. They have also demanded more effective counter-pandemic measures while guaranteeing economic recovery and securing the jobs and incomes of workers. The union also called for better preventive measures to conduct the much-awaited constitutional plebiscite that is scheduled for October 25th. We now go to South Africa, where on Tuesday, 13 slum dwellings in the Ekhanana occupation in Cato Minor, Durban, were demolished in a violent eviction. This eviction was carried out by South Africa's Metro Police, the Anti-Land Invasion Unit, and the notorious private security company Calvin and Family Security. Without a court order, these violent evictions were carried out at the orders of the eThekwini or Durban municipality. The city administration has, throughout the pandemic-induced lockdown, ordered multiple demolitions of informal settlements, leaving hundreds homeless. Authorities have also seized materials used to build these slums, mostly corrugated metal sheets and tarpaulin, to prevent the shack dwellers from rebuilding again. It is also alleged that their cell phones and money were stolen. Two shack dwellers who sustained injury in the course of the violent eviction were hospitalized. The organization of Bhalali Basema Jandolo, which works with shack dwellers, alleged violence on the community leader of the occupation and also a disabled teenager. Since the formation of the large squatting operation by occupation by homeless workers in August 2018, the inhabitants have endured many such attacks, rebuilding the shacks after each demolition. And finally, earlier this week, Colombian social movements held a press conference to denounce the growing violence against the social movements. The movements that participated included Indepaz, the Marcha Patriotica, and the Agrarian Peasant Ethnic and Popular Summit. The movements pointed out that almost 1,000 social activists have been killed since the signing of the peace agreements in 2016 between the government and the FARC guerrilla group. According to a report meticulously prepared by them, between November 2016 and July 2020, 973 social leaders and human rights defenders were assassinated. In addition, during this period, 220 ex-combatants of FARC, that's the Revolutionary Armed Forces of Colombia, were also killed. The report seeks to draw the attention of the Iván Duque government to this alarming reality and demand measures to prevent aggression against them. The organization also said that they would share this information with the Inter-American Commission on Human Rights and the United Nations Security Council. The killings mainly took place in the western provinces of the country and happened around disputes over land and natural resources, illicit crops, drug trafficking and illegal mining. The heightened presence of drug traffickers in the right-wing militia since the disarmament of FARC has been an additional factor. That's all we have time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with major news developments from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.
Dubai.